Right, so in today's video, I'm going to show you a workaround which will allow you to get as many tracks as you want in Ableton Live Lite. And this comes at the cost of a somewhat convoluted workflow, but hey, it's the best we can have unless we want to fork over several hundred dollars to get the full version, right? So the first thing we're going to need to do is understand kind of how this works. So I did some videos on this before and the same principles kind of apply. So the idea is that we have one main project and then we have several extra projects, and each project of course has that 8-track limit, but we can work around that by having several projects, each with its 8 tracks, and they can all stream audio into our main project. And yeah, that's basically it. So to do this, we're going to need to install one piece of software, which depending on which system you're on is going to differ. So on my previous video on this, I was basically explaining the same workflow on Windows. So if you're on Windows, I would suggest you have a look at that one. In the meantime, I've switched to Mac, so I'm going to show you how to do it there today. So I'm going to open up Chrome, or you know, whatever browser it is you're using. I'm going to go to GitHub. There it is, Existential Audio Blackhole, right? And then we can go to this wiki pane right here, installation and download. And this is where you'll end up. You need to give them your email address, your first name, your last name. And once you've filled out those fields, you can just click on subscribe for free Mac download. They will send you an email, and in that email, you will find a link to download the actual driver. And it's gonna come in, gee, I'm not sure now. It's either 2 or 3 versions. The first one, the most simple one, is just one stereo pair, and that could totally work. Me personally, I prefer the 16-channel version because it allows me to make use of the 8 that Ableton Live Lite allows for, right? So I would go with the 16-channel version, and I think they might have a third version as well with something like, I don't know, 32 or maybe 64. That's just overkill, so I would leave that one alone. So download either the 2-channel version or the 16-channel version. And once you've downloaded it, you can just, you know, install it like you would any other software. I can close Chrome now. Now, the next thing is we're going to need to enable the option to open up several instances of Ableton. And this works a little differently on Windows and Mac. On Windows, you can just open your preferences, and in the look and feel pane, you'll have an option that says something along the lines of enable multiple instances or allow multiple instances, something like that. You can just say yes. On Mac, you don't have that, but there is a workaround. You're just gonna need to open your applications folder. And what I did here, as you can see, is I simply right-clicked on Ableton and just duplicated it. And you know, in my case, I have found that I seldom, but sometimes need to work with 5 instances of it. If you need more, by all means, go ahead and just duplicate your way up to the number you think you need. Could be 10, could be 20, however many you need. Right, now that is done, we actually have the option to open up several instances of Ableton, and we have the driver to send audio between them. So this one I have open right here is going to be our main project, and you want to check your audio preferences and set the input device to Blackhole, right? Every other project we open is going to send audio to Blackhole. So Blackhole is going to be the input of our main project. And then as your output device, you can select your external headphones or speakers or whatever it is you have. Then what you want to do is you want to open up a new project. And as you can see, I have already done that. This is the project actually capturing my voice, right? Let me show you in the preferences. So as the input device, I have selected my external microphone. You can use whatever microphone you are using. If you have a sound card, maybe you have several inputs. Or if you're just going to work with MIDI, you're going to have your virtual instruments generate audio. So in that case, I would encourage you to set this to none, or actually no device. Because as you can see down here, whenever you have a certain input device selected, there is a certain latency associated with it, right? So if you set this to no input, that latency is going to go away. Now, it's a very small amount. In my case, it's like 2.67 milliseconds. But still, if you could get that down to 0, why not, right? The important thing is to have your output device selector set to Blackhole. So that means that this project is sending audio directly into Blackhole, which happens to be the input on our master project. So one last thing I want to show you before we actually go ahead and create some tracks. I want to show you the output configuration. configuration for Blackhole. Now, as you can see, there's up to 16 available channels because that's the version of Blackhole that I have installed here. But since Ableton, again, only allows for up to 8 channels, that's the number of channels I have enabled, right? You can just enable and disable channels by clicking on them. And so, yeah, I have enabled 8 because, you know, it wouldn't do me any good to enable 16 of them because I wouldn't be able to use them anyways. Good, I can go out of my preferences now, and let's just go ahead and max out the tracks here. Good, so we have our 8 tracks. One thing I like to do is to color code them, right? So I'm gonna make them all purple, just like the track on the master project, which is gonna receive audio from that project. So there is a certain continuity there. And now all that's left to do here is to select one of our 8 outputs on the master out selector here. And I think since this is the first extra project we opened, we might as well leave this set to 1-2. The important thing is that back in our main project, the input of that track is set to 1-2, right? If I open my preferences, in this master project, Blackhole, as you can see, is not the output, it's the input. So we can access its input configuration. And again, you can see I have enabled 8 channels. So let's say these were all pads, right? I like to separate my projects by type of sound. So I have 8 pad tracks. All of them are gonna go into Blackhole. And specifically, out of the 16 channels Blackhole gives me, I chose the first 2. And then back in our master project right here, that's the channel I selected as an input. It's important to set the monitoring option here to in. And what that does is it will ignore whatever we have or might have on our timeline here, which is nothing, right? And it will only listen to audio coming through the input. So on this master project, you want your tracks to have your monitoring option set to in. And then one extra thing I like to do because it simplifies, well, it simplifies, it's kind of essential. You want to link your projects, right? So that whenever you press play on one project, like this, if I switch to the other one, playback has started there as well. And if I press stop, the same happens on my second project. So I want to link them. And that is it basically. Now, let's say that 8 pads isn't enough. I need another 8 pads in my project. Well, no problem. I can just fire up another instance of Ableton. Let's max out our tracks here as well. Let's color code them as well, right? To avoid any confusion. And since these are pads, I'm going to turn them purple. Now, let's check our preferences as audio input device. Well, we don't need our mic right now, right? So we can set this to no device. And our output device is, of course, Blackhole. Beautiful. See how that input latency went down to 0. That's good. And again, in our master output here, we're going to leave this set to 1-2 because, again, since these are pads, it only makes sense that in our master project, they go to the same one track where we have our other pads as well, right? So maybe we could put a compressor on this one track, processing all the pads or something like that. And of course, I'm going to link this new project as well. Boom, there we go. Okay, let's say we are done with pads. How about some leads? Well, since we're talking about a different kind of sound, I would submit to you that this is the perfect moment to use another pair of channels. We have 8 available, well, 4 pairs actually. So we have 4 pairs available, might as well use up another pair. That's why I'm going to create a new track. It's yellow, so I'm going to set the input this time to 3-4. Monitoring, of course, goes to in. And then I can just open up a new instance of Ableton and it's gonna report a crash, but don't worry, nothing has crashed actually. I mean, all of my other projects are still working and even the one I just created is fine really. So I don't know why it opened this crash report, but you can just ignore it because as you can see, everything is working. So let's check our preferences. Input device, no device, that's good. Output device, Blackhole, but this time around, we want to make sure that our output here goes to 3 and 4. And you can, of course, max out your tracks. You can color code them. I think it was this yellow right here. Of course, every single one of these extra projects has its own return tracks as well. So you can have separate reverbs and delays or whatever effect you want to put in there. Of course, since we are within a project, you can also create some subgroups like this. So we have all the flexibility of having a separate project. And then all of the audio that we create in here is going to go to Blackhole through channels number 3 and 4. And back in our main project, this is the track that is going to capture that audio. And then, of course, if you need more leads, just go ahead and create a new project. And then if you feel you need some drums, you can create yet another project. Now I have maxed out my instances of Ableton, but I can just easily go into my applications folder and then just duplicate one of these in order to have yet another project available to me. I could just duplicate my way up to whatever number of projects I need, and there is no limit actually. I guess your CPU is the limit there. And one last thing I want to mention before wrapping this up. Now you've seen me, you know, switch between projects with a certain confidence, and you might wonder, well, how do you know which project is which, right? It's the naming. So this one where it says Ableton Live 11.2 beta, this is my main project. This one says copy 3. So that's the third extra project I opened. So this one should be the one with the leads. So the yellow one, in fact, it is. Copy 2 is my second project I opened after the main project. So it's actually the third one, I guess, I opened. And this is for some extra pads. And copy is just the first project I opened after my main project. If this is too confusing, remember that you can always change the names of your Ableton copies right here. So I could rename this one to Master if I wanted to, and then this one could be Extra 1, this one could be Extra 2, you know, whatever makes life easier for you. Okay, so I hope this was helpful to you. Now, if you don't like this workflow that much, there is something you can do. I have a video out here on how you can get, well, not unlimited, but several tens of tracks into one single project, so long as you're using MIDI tracks. So that means virtual instruments and samplers. So be sure to check out that video as well. And of course, you can combine both approaches. So you can max out whatever you can do in one single project. And then when you actually need to open up a separate project, you can use this method. But you know, instead of having, I don't know, 10 separate projects, maybe you can do with just 5, right? So that's something to consider as well. And yeah, if you got any questions, leave me a comment. I'll be happy to help. Again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.